This video is sponsored by VoipScan. With the VoipScan app, you no longer need to spend money on mobile communication. When installing, get to the account welcome bonus. If you run out of money, you will be offered to watch a video for views, which will accrue bonus points on your balance, and you can call for free. Call anywhere in the world on urban or mobile. Start saving now. Link is in the description. Hi guys, in this video I'm going to teach you how to convert this 12 volts 120 amps car alternator into a high speed, high torque DC motor that runs on a 12 volts battery. Now guys, as you can see that I have opened up this alternator. This is the base bearing holder with the brushes installed in it, and this is the one that houses the armature winding. Now you can see this is a very old alternator, and the armature winding is all blackened, and you can also see some ruptured insulation points on this armature winding, so I also have to take care of that. Now guys, these four output wires are from the star connected armature winding, which were initially designed to charge the car batteries with the regulator and the rectifier in between. And now the reverse is going to happen, meaning the batteries are going to charge these windings with the controller in between. And guys, you can see this is the bearing, which was really jammed initially, but I have oiled it up and now it is working as good as new. So guys, out of these four wires, there is one wire with four tappings. So we have to remove that wire because that is the center of the star connected winding and it is not needed when we are using this alternator in the motoring mode. So guys, I think this one is the tapping point. So the wire, the blue wires coming out from the controller, will not be connected to this point and it will be connected to the other three wires, and there is only one tapping point in a star connected winding. Now guys, you might have seen my previous video, which is completely related to this video, since that was the part 1 video and this is the part 2 video. There were 4 major drawbacks seen in that video when compared to this video. Firstly, the rotor was completely jammed. It was very difficult to rotate the rotor with hands. Secondly, there were a lot of controller heating issues. Thirdly, although the alternator was running, it was not running at a very good speed. And lastly, it was making a lot of sound while running, which was another major drawback. So guys, I'm planning on removing all those drawbacks in this video. So here, as you can see, I am covering the armature winding with this insulation tape to prevent any further insulation rupturing of the armature winding. Also guys, if you want to watch the previous part of this video, link has been provided in the description along with the purchase link of the controller that I will use in this video, as the video follows. So guys, this is the controller that I will be using to power up the alternator to run it at high speed and with high torque. And you can see guys, the wires coming out from the controller, the blue ones. Here I'm connecting them to the pinouts from the three-phase winding of the armature of this alternator. And remember that we have to leave out the neutral point of the star connected armature winding. Okay, now let's place the alternator and the controller best according to the camera point of view. Yeah, this seems fine. Okay, now the closer view. Here you can see one of the pinouts has been left open and the remaining have been connected. And you can also see red and blue wire feeding the rotor winding or the field winding of this alternator. They are to be extended with this yellow and white wire. Yeah. Okay, so guys, the white and the yellow wires have been connected for extension, and these two wires will be connected to a 12 volts battery for powering up the rotor winding, which will create magnetism inside the alternator. Here I'm also going to use this 15 volts 3 amperes laptop charger that is going to power up the controller. And guys, I used the same laptop charger in my previous video for running this alternator. Also make sure that you connect a positive to the positive and a negative to the negative. That is really important. Now this is the closer view and you can see that red has been defined as VCC and black as ground. At present, the charger is not connected to the power supply cord. Now guys, here I'm going to use this 12 volts bike battery for powering up the rotor winding to create magnetism inside the alternator. Let's measure its voltage. Here it is showing 11.67 volts, means it can be used. Now let's connect the cord to the laptop charger. Now all that is left is connecting the rotor winding to the battery. Now guys, with that being done, let's get started. So guys, it's clearly visible that the performance is much better than it was in the previous video. The noise level has reduced, the starting torque has increased, and also the running speed is very good. Now the closer view. Also guys, there is no controller heating issue anymore, and the controller is working like charm. So it's time to proceed to the next phase, in which I am replacing the laptop charger with this 12 volts 7Ah UPS battery to feed even higher current to the controller. And let's see the performance then. And yes, in place of the battery, 12 volts bike battery, I'm going to use the laptop charger to power up the rotor winding. So guys, the rotor or field winding has been excited and the battery has also been connected to the alternator. It's time to turn the knob. So guys, as you saw that the speed was very high, and here as you can see I'm touching the circuit to make sure that the circuit is not getting heated up, and it is not heating at all. Now guys, as you can see, I have completely removed the laptop charger, and in place of that I'm using battery to power up both the rotor winding and the armature winding. Let's measure the performance now. So guys, this is the maximum performance I achieved for both speed and torque. I believe that is because I fed pure DC to both the rotor and the armature. Now guys, let's do the clockwise and anti-clockwise direction test. At present, it is running in the clockwise direction. Let's change its direction to anti-clockwise. Okay, start. So guys, that would be all about today's video. Thank you so much for watching it. Please hit like and don't forget to share and subscribe. And if you have any queries, you can always ask them in comments. Thank you.